Most species of shark evolved in the oceans before the first trees evolved on Earth. They've been around up to 450 million years and have survived 4 mass extinctions so far. Many of the OG ancient sharks that first started to appear millions of years ago remain virtually unchanged today, like this frilled shark. Yeah, that guy's been through some stuff. One thing's for sure though, you probably wouldn't want to be caught swimming near a shark, let alone a great white. But that is exactly what long-distance swimmer Ben LeCompte could encounter as he journeys across the Pacific Ocean from Japan to San Francisco to raise awareness about ocean health. Seeker will be tracking Ben and bringing you updates on the crew's efforts to collect the most extensive data set on the Pacific Ocean to date. So make sure you check that out. Oh, and to be clear, as Ben draws near to San Francisco, he will be crossing expanses of water that are known great white migration areas. Yikes. Great whites are a species of shark that have recently been discovered to live longer than we previously thought, to around 70 years old or more. However, some sharks can live to be really old, in some cases even living centuries longer than we'd thought before, giving us new insight into both shark ecology and potentially the science of aging. Okay, let's back up though. Scientists have thought that sharks were probably older than originally estimated for about a decade. And I'm talking individual sharks, not sharks as a group of animals. But results from a study published in 2017 used novel methods to definitively determine that yes, sharks live really unexpectedly long lives. Most biologists age fish by measuring features like scales and otoliths, which are bony calcium deposits that are essentially a fish's ear bones. Measuring these is like measuring tree rings and can help us track seasonal growth and organism age. The problem is, sharks lack many of these key structures. They don't have scales the same way other fish do, and they don't have otoliths. Instead, shark scientists have had to make do by counting the calcified growth bands that form along a shark's cartilaginous spine. But this isn't necessarily that accurate, and the older the shark, the harder it is to calculate its age this way. This new study took a different approach, determining age by bomb carbon dating. Bomb carbon dating is based on the atmospheric nuclear tests that were conducted in the 50s and 60s, which deposited a huge spike of radiocarbon into the atmosphere. We can detect the spike of this particular radioisotope in the tissue of animals that were alive during those tests. This most recent study that I mentioned compared bomb carbon dating with the previous age estimates found by just measuring the growth bands. And the growth band estimations for shark age could be off by more than half. This breakthrough is important, not because we're obsessed with being rude and asking sharks how old they are, but because conservation policy is built around organismal lifespans. Greenland sharks, for example, are a near-threatened species of shark that claim the title of the longest living vertebrate on Earth. They could live up to 500 years, and this means that they don't even start to reproduce until they're almost 150 years old. Fishing regulations and environmental protections that impact shark populations of all kinds are built on population models that rely on our knowledge of how these animals survive and reproduce. So if our numbers are wrong, it could spell disaster for conservation efforts. Ever since the extreme lifespan of the Greenland shark was uncovered, scientists have also been interested to see what they and their fellow long-lived shark counterparts could teach us about living for centuries. These organisms, despite being literally as old as the Enlightenment in some cases, still seem to have low incidence of cancer and other age-related diseases. One possible explanation for this is that they spend their lives thousands of meters below the surface in freezing temperatures, which slows down their maturation and their metabolisms. But this is still a matter of scientific investigation, and it remains to be seen if anything of use will come of studying ye old shark health. For now, we can use our improved understanding of their life cycles to inform our conservation efforts in the face of overfishing and changing oceans during climate change. And as for me, there's no way I would endure those living conditions, even for near immortal life. So, do you think you got what it takes to swim across the Pacific Ocean, even now knowing that some sharks have been lurking down there for centuries? Well, then check out how Ben LeCompte prepared for his trip and how he and his team are collecting the most extensive data set ever during his journey. And fun fact, female sharks can use sperm from multiple males, meaning that some pups born at the same time are actually half-siblings. Sharks, guys, they're so cool! I'm Marin, thanks for watching.